Hello everyone! Today we are going to be inspired by lizards and create a pop-up lizard. So the materials you'll need are a cereal box, scissors, and some colored pencils. To get started, just cut the tabs off your cereal box and then cut that cereal box apart. Cut the edges off and get your panel ready. So I'm going to divide my panel into thirds, putting a line up here at the top and a line down here at the bottom. And then I'm going to create a rectangle in the middle for the body. Next, you can see that I'm creating a triangle on the bottom for the tail. I'm going to move this up a little bit to create the arms. And then at the top, I'm going to put some guidelines for where I'm going to put the nose. You might need to make some adjustments, of course. Just trying to get the general look of a lizard or a crocodile. And then I'm going to add some more shapes. Just outlining this. Of course, I'm taking my time in real life, but I sped up the video up in order to preserve time. Okay, put a rectangle here and a rectangle there. Just using these basic shapes, rectangles. Can you kind of see what I'm doing here with the shapes? So I got the basic body here, and now it's time for the fun stuff. Adding patterns and variety, making this a really colorful lizard. A pattern is something that repeats. Right here I got teal, maybe I'll do teal blue. Pattern is repeating shapes. It could also be repeating colors. Looking for some inspiration. So I got this lizard's book and I can see all the beautiful patterns on these different types of lizards. Feel free to pause anywhere and reference these lizards. There's just so much to learn about the world around us. There's so much beauty in animals and reptiles and in nature. All different shapes and varieties of colors and patterns. Wow. Very cool. So I got some ideas and I'm gonna add a lot of shapes here. A pattern of repeating shapes and different colors too. It could be repeating shapes or colors. Whatever types of patterns you create are up to your imagination. Maybe I'll do a wavy line. Add some squares in here. Hey, what are you working on? Just creating a lizard. Neat. Variety. Variety is a number of different types of things, and I want to add a lot of variety in the shapes and the patterns that I use on my lizard, just to make it more interesting for me and the audience. Time to cut this out. Now, I'm going to show you a few special cutting techniques. Cut the biggest shapes first. Skip those little tiny details. and it's hard to get into some of these little tiny areas. So you need to make a little cut for you to use your scissors to cut out of. I'm gonna slow it down here so you can see. So I folded that cardboard up and now I'm just cutting on each side around. I'm gonna find the biggest shape here to cut out and I'm just gonna cut around those little tiny details and cut the biggest shapes out first. I'm gonna cut a little slice out the sides so I can fit my scissors in on each side. Move this up, kind of fold it up so it's easier for me to cut. Again, I'm just gonna carefully take my time cutting that big shape out, cut a slice out the side, cut a slice out, and that way it's easier to fit my scissors in and remove that piece of card or of cereal box. I spent so much time on coloring this and drawing it that I don't want to cut anything accidentally, so I'm really wanting to take my time. Uh-oh, I just cut too much on that arm, so it's a little bit sliced, but just, again, trying to take your time and carefully cut in these little areas. Making room for your scissors by cutting a little slice out. Now it's time for the triangles. So I'm just gonna cut those little triangles out one by one. See how I'm lining it up right at the biggest part of my scissors. So my scissors are kind of gently eating those little triangles away, one at a time, opening my scissors big and just carefully cutting these triangles out. Really careful, because I spent a lot of time on this and I don't want to accidentally cut one of the toes off. If you do, that's okay, you can glue it back on, but if you just take your time and really pay attention and focus on what you're doing, you shouldn't have a problem. After a lot of years of cutting, I've tried to figure out the most efficient way to cut big shapes, tiny shapes, and everything in between. All right, now it's time to score. Prepare this cereal box to be folded. So if you have a ruler, you can use that. I'm gonna close my scissors and just run them along the edge, sort of like I would my pencil. I'm gonna mark where I want this part to be folded up. And I'm just scoring that area so that it's easier to fold up and it's a nice clean fold. Again, my scissors are closed. And essentially, this is just prepping this thick piece of cereal box to be folded up nice and evenly. See how it's nice and even? If you don't define where you're gonna fold it, it might get a little bit inconsistent and uneven. So when you score it with your scissors, you're defining where you want it to fold. And then you'll have a nice clean fold. Let's see. Now it's time for the eyes. So for the eyes, I'm just gonna create a big oval, essentially. And the bottom part is gonna be folded up. Folded like a little flap so that it can stand upright, the eye can be upright. And I want to color this in a really cool way, so let me look for some inspiration. What kind of eye do I want? That one's cool. Okay, I'm gonna add a pattern to really draw the attention of other lizards or even the audience. Maybe this is going to be a puppet, a little puppet show. So I have two pieces of cardboard here, or cereal box. And you're going to see why in a second. So I'm going to trace it too, so I can use it for another eye. I'm folding that little flap down. Now, see how you can stand that eye up? Well, look at the back. I want to cover the back so that it blends in with my lizard. So I have my second piece of cereal box, and I'm gonna draw a cool design. And then of course I'm gonna color it, line it up, make sure that it matches size-wise. And now I'm gonna glue it to the back. And I'm gonna hold it there for at least 10 or 15 seconds. Now I'm gonna set it aside while it dries and work on the next eyes. Remember I traced it? Okay, I got my second eye done and now it's time to glue it on. If you have some extra on the edges that you wanna remove, just clean that edge up. Put some glue on, hold it down, and wait, of course. Here is my pop-up lizard. I hope you enjoy creating yours. Good luck, everyone!